basketball fans, great matchup for you tonight between the San Francisco Dons and the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. Number 31 does a wonderful job in using his upperclassman leadership to inspire his team on the floor.
He finds a way to bring that valuable team support to the team without losing his own game.
The Fighting Irish will clearly rely on him to make contributions on both ends of the floor. The Fighting Irish, by all accounts, should have an easy time of it tonight, Dick Vitale. How do they ensure that victory, though?
They should listen to me and follow the simple keys, baby. First, give them the ball. Let them attack from down low. Next, take care of the ball on offense and play aggressive perimeter defense. Thirdly, you can't win, baby, if you don't get the glass. You must rebound. Rebounding is the key.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action. See what's in store. Perfectly executed.
Instant replay, please.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Number three, pump fakes. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he did exceptionally well.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. Pump fakes. He up fakes. There's a double team waiting there.
Oh, what a strip, Brad.
I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. The center handles the feed. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off. The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
Shows patience waiting for the reset. This is college basketball at its best, Dick.
Oh, I couldn't agree with you more, Mr. Nessler. We are so lucky that we get to go to all these schools and experience the mayhem firsthand.
Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Goes up for two. And he missed. Inside. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Doesn't go. Newton handles the pass. Inside. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
Looking for the foul. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. This place will be in complete chaos if this defense can get a stop right here. Trying to draw some contact.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He's got a nice shot fake. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
Brad, despite his performance, he has been unable to get his teammates all on the same page. There's a lot of confusion and lack of focus down here right by the bench. He continues to stress to them, relax, play your game. He can't do this alone, Brad.
He'll regroup the offense. He pump fakes. The power forward receives the pass. Pass down low. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block for the bucket and in and out. Now they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from right of the circle. He misses it. Trying to pack it inside. He makes a nice shot fake. He does the sweet fake shot. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Getting to 17 feet.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. Zayla receives the ball. Off the rim and no good. Fed the low block. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler and he lost it.
With the long bomb. Tickles a twine. At halftime, the Dons are behind by three. San Francisco has turned the ball over a lot more than normal in that first half.
They're very sloppy in moving the ball tonight. And as a result, turnovers are piling up like dirty laundry.
Second half, Dick, our focus player update. And what's he got to focus on, or what do his teammates have to focus on?
I think his teammates got to set him up somehow. They got to run some sets to get him free for some good shots.
Looking for a good shot.
Double team now, bad angle.
For two.
I tell you, terrific shot. Really impossible to get a piece of that baby.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. He shoots from the top of the key. Way off target. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Moving it around the perimeter. Gave it up. He intercepts it. Working it around the perimeter.
I sometimes wonder what it would be like to be a skywalker. Elevating and throwing it down, Mr. Nestler. How much fun would that be?
That's why I love this game, Dick, for that reason alone.
I'll tell you, Brad. With the best home records probably have incredible school pride. They don't call it the six man for no reason.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting the good inside angle. A poor job defensively. No help. I mean, that is post play at its best.
He shoots from left of the circle. And he hits the three.
Let's see if it looks as good on a replay.
Hunt is emotionally fired up.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Here's a double team. Number 44 with the fake.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Fakes it. 10 seconds to put up a shot. Shot goes up and in.
Hey, there's just too much space.
Dick, when I see those types of things, I just get chills.
Hey, this place is remarkable. The noise is deafening.
Working around the perimeter. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He couldn't get it to fall. Looking to move it around the perimeter. On the inside. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Guys, he seemed very focused from the beginning. His game face was on, and he understands it's his time to perform. Let's send it back over to you.
Great defense.
The defender is still applying great blow pressure, Brad. Up and inside.
They'll work it around the arc. The Dons have a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad. I tell you, does a great job getting post position. Hey, Brad, that shot's impossible to stop. It's unbelievable. It's not utilized enough.
He takes it away. We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. I wouldn't mind seeing him change things up a little bit, Dick, here.
I wouldn't be surprised either.
I knew this was going to be a dandy, baby.
The lead is down to three. The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
The Dons go to the line for the first time in this game. Gets his first. Second one is no good. Looking for a good shot. Shot's there if he wants it. He shoots from long range. He takes the board. Dumps it in. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Duncan handles the pass. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Nick. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession or timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. Clock stop with a foul. And yet another foul. At the free throw line. Sinks it. Makes the second shot.
All you need is a score and a stop to have a chance.
We're about ready to start things. That makes it a four-point lead.
These kids are here to fight, Brad.
He shoots.
They have to foul to put them on the line and hope they miss.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. Go to the line. No doubt about it. Shot.
It's a TL, baby. Hey, it's nail-biting time. Where's my BTP-er? Who's going to step up and make the big shot?
we'll see if they've decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
He intercepts it. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Good teams will get to the line often, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
Hits the second shot. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you got to think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
Too strong. How do these kids get to the spot so quickly on defense, Dick?
Hey, great basketball savvy and good coaching. It's all about doing the little things, baby.
Our focus player update, our final one of the ball game, and he led his team to victory.
I tell you one thing, he really responded to the challenge, and that led them to the winner's circle.
Notre Dame saw their lives flash before them as they finally pull this one out.
They expected to be the victor. They just didn't expect it to be this close.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.